In this tutorial, we will be going over the different transparency types in PopcornFX and rotations. We are iterating on our effect from the last tutorial, and we will be creating some simple smoke for our fire. We will start by creating an event multiplier node and a particle layer node. Remember to rename your layers so that you can keep track of them. Toggle the fire and ember layers so that we can see what we are doing more clearly. For the smoke, we need about 20 particles spawning per second indefinitely. Double-click your smoke layer and add a billboard renderer. So far, in all of our examples, we have only used the default transparency type, which is additive. This time, we will use another transparency type called alpha blend. We have created a simple example to show the difference between the two transparency types, and we will compare them with different effects. On the left, the three circles are all using the additive transparency type. This mode stacks the color values of particles on top of one another so that when a lot of them overlap, their color will shift towards white and begin glowing if there is any glow post-processing enabled. Depending on the game engine, there might also be lens flares. This is meant to imitate the additive color model. On the right, the circles are all using the alpha blend transparency type. This type of transparency does not stack the color values of particles. It simply uses the alpha value as the blending source. Here, if the alpha value is set to 255, or 1 on a normalized scale, then the circle that is closest to the camera will cover the circles further away. Naturally, this means that for particles using alpha blend, sorting order matters. Whereas for particles that use additive, the color values all get added the same way regardless of which particle is closer to the camera. So the sorting order doesn't matter in this case. In this example, we have a preview of what our smoke will behave like by the end of this tutorial. On the left, we are using the additive transparency type, and on the right, we are using alpha blend. Additive clearly does not work for this effect because the smoke appears to glow where the particles are the most dense. Alpha blend works a lot better in this case. After you've set the transparency type to alpha blend, we will add some movement to our particles. Let's create the same basic movement as the embers from our last tutorial. Add a physics node. Then, add a local position to world node and change its vertical position to negative 0.5. For the direction, add a local direction to world node with a VRAN node. We don't want our smoke splaying out too much, so with the VRAN node selected, in the properties panel, lower the inner value to about 0.1 and lower the outer value to about 0.5. Next, we'll add our wind. To be consistent, we will use the same values as our embers. 3 for the vertical direction of the wind, and 0.5 for the drag. As last time, we will add a turbulence node. You can play with the values, but for our purposes, we will only change the timescale. We're going to add some rotation to make the movement of our smoke more interesting. First, change the size of the particles to 0.1 and their lifespan to 5 so that we can properly see what's going on. Add a rotation node and link it to the rotation pin of the billboard renderer. It is important to note that in almost all other templates, the angles are measured in degrees. However, the billboard renderer and the legacy rotation node's rotation values are all measured in radians. We are currently working on fixing this in the following updates. Because of this, we will continue to work in degrees, but we will make sure to place a degrees to radians node to convert our values at the end. In the properties panel, we will mainly focus on two values, the rotation angle and the scalar rotation speed. The rotation angle represents the screen space rotation angle, while the scalar rotation speed represents the amount of rotation per second. We want to add more variation to our smoke, so we will make sure that both of those properties can be seen in the node graph. Then, for the rotation angle, we will pick a random value between negative 180 and 180. This will give each particle a random angle. Now, add a degrees to radians node and link it to the legacy rotation node. Now that our particles are randomly rotated when they spawn, we also want them to rotate throughout their lifespan. We can do this by using the same random floats. We will scale them down so our rotations are slower. Now, we'll change the size. We want our smoke to start off small and then grow as it moves up. Create a curve over time and curve node. Raise the right hand point to 1. Go to the billboard renderer and change the diffuse texture to flames. This texture provides simple shapes for us to create smoke with. With the atlas enabled, subdivide the texture with a 4x4 division. In order to add some variety to our smoke, we'll randomize the texture that each particle displays. Make sure that the texture ID is visible in the node graph, then add a random node and pick which textures you'd like to display. We chose the textures between 3 and 7. Next, we will untoggle the fire and embers layers so we can properly match our smoke to our other particle layers. We can now clearly see that the smoke lifespan is too long. You can either simply lower the value or add a bit of variation to it. After that is done, we need to fix the color of our smoke. The lighter the fire affects the smoke by making it appear more red the closer it is to the heat source. Then, as the smoke rises, it turns almost black before fading away. We will fake this effect with a color curve. Create a curve over time and curve node. Then, add 4 dimensions to the curve and a subdivision. You can either right-click and select subdivide, or you can alt-click. This will add another point projected along your curve. Make sure the subdivision is a little closer to the right so that you can see the change in color without the fire layer covering it. In order to set the colors, we can either manually move each curve, select the points we want to change and click the color picker, or we can click the small tabs right above the color preview. First, we'll make our smoke start out a desaturated red with an alpha of 0. Then, we'll take the middle point and raise the alpha value to about 150 and change the color to a dark gray to avoid pure black smoke. You can move the tabs if you drag them so you can adjust the transition from red to gray in your smoke easily. If we want to be precise about where to start our color transition, there is a new feature in the V2.2 PopcornFX editor that allows us to pause our effect and scrub through the timeline. The smoke and the embers behave normally. However, when you scrub backwards, they randomize. This is because their movement depends on a lot of random variables that the editor cannot predict. If you want to change this, go to Edit, Editor Preferences, or press Ctrl-P. Navigate to the Timeline section and check Force Determinism. This will allow you to scrub backwards through the timeline, but it won't force the effect to be entirely deterministic. We will talk about this in more depth in another tutorial. Even with the effect paused, any changes you make in the node graph will get updated. Now, you will have completed your effect. That's all for this tutorial. We hope you found it useful. Stay tuned for our next one.